Har du træt af at være YouTuber?
Nej.
Nej?
Men jeg er bange for, at blive, hvis man bliver kendt. Det er bange for.
Hvad er det kendt?
Nej, men sådan rigtig kendt, det vil jeg være bange for at være. Du ved sådan, hver gang man går ud, der er nogen, der...
Den er ikke engang inkluderet på listen.
Nej, det burde den måske være.
Så de fleste vil se det som en god ting.
Nej, det tror jeg, det ved jeg ikke.
What's up, my boys? Welcome to a new video.
We have been YouTubers for 3 years, almost 4 years now, and it's been a long journey, and we love it, but we wanted to talk about the worst things about being a YouTuber, and this is very new content for our channel, but since we are now daily vlogging, we figured that why not try some new
different
video
things.
Ideas. So maybe tomorrow will be 10 best things, but we're negative people, I am, so with no further ado.
The first thing on our list is actually something that keeps going on, because that's the pressure that is on you to keep creating new content, to keep making something that people want to watch, to be creative, to keep doing these things. And you also want to be better every time. So every time you posted one video, you want the next one to be better. And that's a pressure that really can stress you out. And that's why a lot of YouTubers, they burn out. It's constantly that your brain has to work. And for some of us, it's very difficult.
Once you've published a video, you're not done. It's the next one, and the next one, and it just never stops. So when we started YouTube, we wanted to be full-time YouTubers. It wasn't a hobby. We just went all in from the beginning. And the worst thing is the anticipation of never making it.
You should keep in mind that we were vlogging for almost 3 years before we started getting views and subscribers. And every time we posted a video that we thought was really cool, nobody watched it. I remember we were in Namibia and we were like, this is the videos of Namibia. And I think it has 500 views. So you keep hoping that you make it, but you never know if you make it. And even now, like, we've been wanting to reach that 100k mark for 2 years now. And it's just so difficult. So that is definitely some of the toughest. Yeah, please subscribe. For the algorithm also, leave a comment, guys.
The constant ups and downs of being a YouTuber is extremely hard for both me and Amalia. It's like views and subscribers and engagement. It's like if you have one good video, then the next video is terrible. You're like, what happened? What went wrong? Is YouTube hating us, or are you guys not liking what you're seeing?
Did we say something offensive that we didn't know? That's
yeah.
Also one of the things.
So it's like it's up and down all the time. Nothing ever goes up only, but sometimes it's down, 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 and then a little bit up, and it can be like that for long periods of times. And there's nothing to do other than just continuing. And we had 2 years of that, where it's just like 30 views. In the first hour of publishing.
And then sometimes you are in a period where it's so super good. Like when we went on ATP in the winter last year, we were like, now the ball is rolling, now it's gonna be good. Then the first lockdown happened and our channel just completely stopped. These are the kind of things that just keeps happening, and they can be really tough on you. The next one is not earning enough money.
Or earning money at all.
Exactly. When we started the YouTube thing, and until recently, we had to pay for everything ourselves. We had to pay for everything out of our savings and from our other businesses. And still today, we don't earn enough money on YouTube to finance the lifestyle that we have. So we have to take the money from other businesses that we have and
yeah.
From investments that we have.
I mean, as with any startup, it takes time before you earn money.
Yes.
But with YouTube, it's not a product you're selling. Of course, it's a video and people might like it and whatever. You might have a lot of followers. But with sponsors, we have a few now. It took like 3 years to get decent sponsors that we love. But we don't know if, you know, next month they might be like, no, we're done with you, move on. And then you have like, then you're just losing like an important part of your income.
Yeah.
And that really is a source of stress as well.
Constantly, actually.
And so, yeah, YouTube is definitely not a good business unless you are in the 1% or even higher.
The next one is probably one of the most stressful for us, and that is that you are at the mercy of the YouTube algorithm.
YouTube owns you.
I own you. You're my bitch.
If they decide that travel content is not relevant right now, which they have for the last year, basically, yeah, it's like you're not getting any views. Right when we were about to take off, you know, as you said, in January last year after we went on national TV, we just like smacked right in the head by the YouTube algorithm.
And nobody can figure out the YouTube algorithm, and yeah, they keep changing it. So every time you're like, okay, this is what we should do, this is working, boom, it changes.
Yeah, that's why we also say, you know, like and comment for the YouTube algorithm, because
it might work.
We know for a fact that it's part of the algorithm that, you know, people liking the video and commenting means, you know, they might actually really enjoy what they're seeing. So maybe we should push this video to more people.
Yes.
When you make YouTube videos, you spend most of your time awake doing it. So that means that you pretty much put all your eggs in one basket. And that is a bit terrifying in a way, because we have all you guys on YouTube, and it's very hard for us to just move you to emails or another platform. If YouTube suddenly shuts down or whatever, shuts our channel down, then bye-bye Bogota. I mean, it's a bit scary thought. They own us.
So even though Jon and I, we do have our online magazine, I'm the only one working on the magazine right now, and that's actually our main source of income. And because I'm the only one working on a two-man's job, this magazine is gonna decrease in value as well.
I think the scariest part of being a YouTuber is that we might be irrelevant tomorrow. There's a lot of examples of YouTubers who, you know, from one day to the other, or slowly just become irrelevant. Because people, they get sick of their content. It's not relevant anymore what they're talking about. For example, being a travel YouTuber, I mean, traveling is not really a thing anymore. But of course people are still dying to travel, so of course they're still watching those videos. But there are many examples on YouTubers with hundreds of thousands of views, if not millions, that just don't get any views anymore. Amalie, do you hate mean comments?
Actually, not that much, but we do get a lot of mean comments and judgmental comments and just people judging us all the time. And that is definitely something that is horrible about being a YouTuber, but it's also a part of the package. I mean, when you devote yourself to your audience in the way that we do as YouTubers, you will also have to expect some feedback in both lanes, you know? It can be really tough when sometimes people say something where you know that there might be some truth in what they're saying, like when they ask if I'm pregnant, or like, oh, Amalie, she's pregnant now because I got a little chubby over the last year. That's kind of like, that's so mean. Keep it to yourself, I'm just fat, okay?
I think the worst thing is when people there, they say something that is just blatantly false, and other people are upvoting it, like, yeah, you know, suddenly what is completely false becomes the truth. And it's like you can't reply to all the comments, you know, but even if you reply, it's like, it's too late.
We have put this on the list, but I kind of feel like Jon doesn't see this as a bad thing at all. But the amount of money that you spend on gear as a YouTuber, it's insane, okay? We spend so much money because we want the quality to be good, we want the sound to be good, we want good editing programs and photo editing programs and all these things that you just need that people don't really think about watching the videos. They're like, you guys might have so much money. This is where they are. This is our money, right here.
I mean, obviously you don't have to buy this much equipment to make YouTube videos. You can use your iPhone if you want, but no matter what, if you want to make future-proof videos, 4K, you need a computer that can tackle that in the editing. Like, one thing I've learned is that if you make travel videos like we do, where the visual appeal is important, changing from the old drone to the new drone huge difference. And it also costs a lot to make videos, you know, when we go out and eat at restaurants. or, you know,
if you want to rent a car or travel, or you need to stay at a hotel because you're going to sell the Estrella.
Exactly.
The last one is that the camera is your life. We bring the camera everywhere and we document everything. And even when you decide to not document and you're like, let's go on a vacation, let's not do anything, let's just enjoy a place in Portugal, for example. Everything we're thinking about is, oh, I wish I brought the camera because this is so beautiful. So you're always thinking about content and filming, and it's stressful, but it's also nice.
I don't think that we have been on any trips, Amalia, together without the camera since we started making YouTube videos.
Yes, one trip to Madeira with our friends.
Okay, that's true. One trip
for the 3 days.
One trip for, and we've been traveling non-stop for 3, almost 4 years.
Filming also means that we very often eat delicious food, but very cold, because we have to film it before we eat it.
that is actually the worst thing
That's
of being a YouTuber.
That's actually very annoying. But we're lucky to eat it anyway, you know.
But
guys, that was it for this video. So, obrigada por ver o vídeo. Até logo.
And I don't have to remind you to like the video and comment for the YouTube algorithm because you already did that. Até logo, guys. See you tomorrow. And there's nothing I can do for you. If you don't stay classy too.